Hi, I'm Dr. Swati, Senior Nutritionist for HealthifyMe. Today we will be discussing about lifestyle disorders, very many causes that causes these lifestyle disorders and how you can prevent them. So let's start with some statistics. You know, at the global level, around 14.2 million people die every year at the premature stage of 30 to 59 years. This is because of non-communicable diseases like hypertension, diabetes, and cardiovascular diseases. At the national level, 61% of total mortality rate is contributed because of these non-communicable diseases again. India is known as the diabetic capital of the world, having the highest percentage of diabetics in the world. Also, it ranks one when it comes to cardiovascular diseases. People suffering from CVDs are highest in India. And India comes just second when it comes to people having or at the stage of obesity. This all statistics sounds really scary. It really scares me as well. But why is it so? Why is it happening? Why its prevalence is getting higher every year? That is a question. That is because of our lifestyle, the way we are leading our life, and the disorders which are happening because of the consequences of such a lifestyle we are leading is lifestyle disorder. So what is the major reason why these lifestyle disorders are happening or increasing at such a rapid rate? It is because of globalization. Globalization, in simple terms, means advancement. Advancements in our lifestyle, the way we are leading our life. This is resulting in a higher level of lifestyle disorders, a higher consequences and occurrence. So why? Let's talk about, like, in normal, in general way, why is it happening? Nutrition transition is the main reason. Why is it happening? Because of globalization. Nutrition transition is like in older times, like we have our ancestors, they used to take simple food, simple coarser grains, dals, legumes, salads, whole fruits. And now, in spite of having chapatis, we are more into like pizza base. In spite of having more of dals, we are more into like dal-based tortillas or nachos. In spite of having like whole fruits and vegetables, we are more into fruit loops and vegetable rings, which are baked, processed, and available like in such a huge amount all around us in the market. Is it not so? It is. These are the reasons. And we just not take it because it's delicious. We just not take it because it's available, but we also take it because it's the demand of time. Globalization again. People are working. They are so much involved in their professionalism. They hardly have any time to cook three meals a day, right? They definitely would ask for something which is convenient, which is available to them. And this is what nutrition transition is because of globalization. People from coarser grains, from healthy natural food items, they are transiting towards what? The commercial food, the processed, the packaged food which is available. And this is the reason why it is happening. The second reason, apart from nutrition transition, is the physical activity. Desk work, more of desk job. They sit for like 8 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours in front of their laptops, onto the desk, and they're just working and working. Least physical activity, sedentary lifestyle. So when you are not burning out calories as compared to what you are consuming, that nutrient, that calorie will be going somewhere, right? It will be dissipating. So it just gets precipitated right into our body. It gets reserved into like into fat, into sugar, just name it. All the nutrients that are dangerous to your body, it will just get reserved over here. And this is the leading cause why I'm talking about that there is a high prevalence of non-communicable diseases. Let's talk about, in general, take like 5 non-communicable diseases which are very, very much categorized into lifestyle disorders. Hypertension. A child who is in 10th standard or 12th standard is facing a problem of hypertension. Yes, stress is a reason. Lot of studies, stress is there. You have to cross so many competitions, stress is there. But it is also, it can be something which can be managed with the good lifestyle, with good dietary practices. It can be managed. So why is it happening? Hypertension is a major cause when there is an imbalance in your sodium intake. Sodium is a mineral, okay? And food, every food naturally contains some sodium. But when we are adding externally so much of sodium, which is present in packaged and processed foods, chips are there, crackers are there, so many things. All the processed and packaged food, they contain a good amount of sodium into it. Similarly, even the frozen foods, that is nowadays considered as a very convenient food option, and we opt for it. But the amount of sodium that is being used in its preservation is something you cannot even imagine. And when you are making your body, like, you know, being supplied with such a high amount of sodium, so somewhere it will create an imbalance. It is going to fluctuate, it's going to create a disbalance between your natural composition, your natural body composition, and what you are making your body subjected to from outside, right? Similarly, let's talk about the cardiovascular diseases. These cardiovascular diseases, it can be arteriosclerosis, that is when lot of fat, it is depositing into your arteries and veins, creating a problem in the blood flow. Similarly, stroke. All these are categorized into cardiovascular diseases. Why is it happening? Again, the preserved and packaged foods that we take, the bakery food items, because of their shelf life, bread is the most convenient option. Let's go for it. Bun, burger, these are the most convenient options. Let's go for it. Burger is the most tastiest thing that I can even have it. French fries, amazing they taste, I know. But they are so, so high in saturated fats, especially. All the preserved packaged foods, they contain so high amount of preserved saturated fats for their processing, for their manufacturing, for their storage, that it is just accumulating on our body. Saturated fat has a tendency to deposit and not just get excreted out from your body. And this, you know, this precipitation inside the body, this deposition is something which will cause a problem like heart strokes and heart failures even. You have to take care of that. Even high carbs, when we take lot of sugars, we are taking in form of ice creams, in form of so many like delicacies around us. This high sugar, like I said, when there is an imbalance between how much calorie you are consuming and how much you're burning out, this high carbs, this high sugar will get deposited into your body, converting into fat, converting into glycogen. The very next lifestyle disorder, which is why we say that India is the diabetic capital of the world, in fact, is diabetes. Why diabetes is happening? Is it just because we eat too much of sugar, or we are having like 3 to 4 tablespoons of sugar every day? No. Invisible sugar, invisible dangerous nutrients that we are taking in more amount than what our body requires, it is causing diabetes. Yes, sugar is one of the reasons that will cause an imbalance between your natural body blood glucose level and the what one you are creating from outside. But other reasons are also responsible, like obesity. High amount of fat, high amount of carbs, when it is there in your body, then what happens? It accumulates in our body. And our body cells get resistant to an insulin hormone, the hormone which regulates your blood glucose level. So if I'm wearing a raincoat, raindrops cannot cause me any harm, cannot cause any effect over me. It's just that when the body cells are covered with extra of carbohydrate, with extra of fat, in that case, insulin cannot give any kind of effect. And there, the blood sugar level showed an increment without its proper metabolism. This results in increased amount of the blood sugar level. It can be postprandial, it can be even fasting blood glucose level. So it's not just the amount of sugar, but the amount of every nutrient which will ultimately, after metabolism, will get stored in your body. Apart from these like hypertension, cardiovascular diseases, diabetes that we have talked about, there are two more diseases which are prevailing, and they are like, their rate is increasing at such a higher pace that nowadays every first person out of 3 persons are getting this disease. This is PCOD, that is polycystic ovarian Down syndrome, and the other one is thyroid. It can be hyperthyroidism, it can be hypothyroidism as well. So what is the reason that this PCOS, that is polycystic ovarian syndrome, and thyroid is causing it such, or prevailing at such a higher rate? It is also because this nutrition transition where you are more deviated, where you are having more of nutrients like saturated fats, sugar and salt. This is causing an imbalance between hormones. Protein is a major nutrient which forms your hormone, followed by fat, good fat, omega-3 fatty acid. But we are not able to categorize between good fat or bad fat. we are not able to categorize between good protein or bad protein or what should be the amount of protein. This is the reason why imbalance is creating more of hyperthyroidism, hypothyroidism is happening, more of PCOS problem is happening. So along with a good diet, a balanced diet, a good physical exercise is also necessary. Like I said, a balance between how much calorie you are consuming and burning out makes a very great difference. If there is more of calorie consumption as compared to what you are burning out, it will definitely, it will result in accumulation of that calorie into your body. Similarly, if you are having less of calories, having this, kind of sense in our mind that, yeah, if we'll have less calories, that means we are making ourselves devoid of as such problems like obesity or, getting overweight. No, has to be a balance. So if you are eating less calorie than what you are burning out, then there will be a nutritional deficiencies in the long run. So you have to keep in mind that there is a balance between calorie consumption and burning out with good physical activity as well. Walking, cardio, lots of exercises are there. Even 15 to 20 minutes of brisk walk will do good, but you have to make sure that you are doing exercise. And similarly, another thing, cancer. 12% of total deaths in the country is contributed because of cancer. And why is it happening? It's not just happening because it's genetic, it's not in our genes, but the food that we are eating, it contains so many of chemicals, it contains so many of preservatives, it contains so many of additives that modulate, that changes the category, the configuration of our genes. And that also causes changes in our cell metabolism at the cellular level, of course, that can cause cancer. So you have to make sure that what kind of food that you are eating. So it's in your hand, whether you can control these diseases or not, because it is not something that can be prevented with vaccination. You just cannot, replace that. Okay, the child will not eat chips, or you're making a person or infant resistant to chips in the later life by giving a vaccination now. No, it's up to you, whether you can change your lifestyle, you can modify your lifestyle towards a healthy diet pattern, towards a healthy lifestyle with physical exercises, or just keep on eating medicines. It's totally up to you. This is why we say, just define your lifestyle in a healthy way, and it will affect whether it can be a disorder or something which is very healthy. So it's up to you, totally. This is just a glimpse of what is on its way in the coming weeks ahead. But next week, it's Mother's Day special for all the special mamas out there. A very hearty and happy Mother's Day to you all in advance from me. So stay tuned to our channel for the coming time ahead. See ya.